I would now like to invite Professor Sharan, scholar in residence, on the stage to please come forward and felicitate Professor Sudhir K. Jain with a shawl and memento. The memento that we will present to him is a custom handcrafted sculpture of the iconic Lal Minar on campus. The sculpture has been made by Mr. Sangam Vankhade, who is a stone sculpture artist from Panchmahal, Gujarat. I invite Professor Sharan and Professor Jain on the stage.
Thank you, Professor Sharan. Now I request Professor Jain to please say a few words.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being here today and for organizing this wonderful evening, and particularly thankful to everybody who traveled long distances in many cases. Over the years, I have met amazing set of people. Many of them are here, but many, many more. And whatever I am today has been because of accident of having met these wonderful people. Very prominently, if I start to think about my teacher when I was a 11-year-old boy who taught me mathematics, but taught me a lot of values. Half of his lecture will be mathematics, but the other half will be something else. And he passed away a few years back, remained in touch with me over the years, all this life. My teachers at Roorkee, my teachers at Caltech, the colleagues, students, friends I made at Kanpur, at Gandhinagar, numerous well-wishers. It has been absolutely a joy to meet very, very wonderful people who have helped me, who have inspired me, who have supported me. I remember some years back, a colleague from IIT Kanpur was sitting in my Chandkheda office with me, and the time was around 7 or 7.30. And we were discussing at what time I go home, and it was a little embarrassment to say that I go home late. And every time somebody asks me what time I go home, and I say I'm going home late, there is a certain amount of guilt that comes with the fact that when I go home late, in Kanpur, I would come to office after dinner and do my work, the real creative work, the writing work I would do after coming back past dinner to my office. But in Gandhinagar, somehow I said I will go home, have dinner, and then not come back. What that means is that many of my colleagues have to be around me for whatever reasons to supposedly support me. So there was this colleague visiting me from Kanpur, and he asked me, you know, what time you go home? And there was a certain amount of guilt with which I said that, you know, this is the time. And he remarked something very interesting. At that time, between Prabhuji and Parikshit Bhai, I don't know if they are here in the hall today. Parikshit is here, and I don't know if Prabhu is in the hall. One of them was bringing chai for us. And this gentleman from Kanpur IIT, he remarked, he said, you know what? The enthusiasm I see in this man in bringing chai for us at 7 o'clock in the evening, that is the reason you are able to carry on the work. If this guy is resenting being here, you won't enjoy your work. And I must say that I've been very, very fortunate in finding a Prabhu or a Parikshit or a Malkhan. I don't know if Malkhan is here. Malkhan bhai hai idhar? So there is a gentleman here, Malkhan. Isne bahut chai pilaya hai office mein. रात में ऑफिस में दिन में सैटरडे में संडे में संतोष है कोमल है गौरव है देयर मेनी पीपल एट द वेरी पर्सनल लेवल हु हैव सपोर्टेड मी बट देन देयर मेनी मेनी अदर्स हु हैव गॉन रियली आउट ऑफ द वे सत्येंद्र कुमार वॉज हियर ही डिडंट मेंशन इट व्हेन आई बिकेम डीन आरपीजी ही बिकेम अनऑफिशियल coordinator for the international relationship part of it. I couldn't give him any designation, I couldn't give him any official recognition. But then he carried on that burden, or Dheera Sanghi, who carried on the burden of being the key person for alumni relations, even though, again, I could not give him anything. So I have been very fortunate to have some wonderful people at IIT Kanpur, at IIT Gandhinagar to work with. And whatever I am today has been due to those people. But I think there is something else that happened in my life. When I came back from United States, I knew India can be tough. In 1984, India wasn't that easy. I had done my PhD in earthquake engineering, and I knew structural dynamics. We used to use structural dynamics as a tool. And when I ended up joining IIT Kanpur, where there was no earthquake engineering, I realized that it's not important to do earthquake engineering. It is important to make some useful contributions. And my first project proposal was written for Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, ONGC, in an offshore structures problem. My second proposal was written in earthquake engineering. But my third proposal, again, was written on offshore pipelines. The idea was that there was a little bit of situation where most of the earthquake engineering in our country was concentrated in one particular institution. And I had been warned and forewarned that there is very little chance of you being able to do earthquake engineering at Kanpur. And my thought was, all right, we will do whatever we can. And therefore, my two out of three first proposals were written in offshore structures. In fact, 2 years after I joined Kanpur, I spent one full summer in Indian Space Research Organization in Sriharikota, working on wind analysis. And I thought, if not earthquake engineering, if not offshore structures, I could at least do something in wind engineering. Fortunately, something else happened around that time. I was teaching earthquake engineering course at Kanpur, and there was a particular handbook on earthquake engineering that was published by Bureau of Indian Standards. And when I started to teach the class, and I started to look at the solved examples of that handbook, I was horrified to realize that most of the examples had been solved incorrectly and published by Bureau of Indian Standards. So I made a student, solve those problems correctly. And we typed it. In those days, typing was a very difficult task because we didn't have word processing, and you had to literally beg and plead with a typist who can do the typing with the symbols and equations. So we typed the manuscript, and we sent it for publication. And we knew that Indian Society of Earthquake Technology will never publish it because key people who were involved in handbook were actually going to be affected. I was very pleasantly surprised they actually published it. The next step came, another student came, and I said, you know, I have been teaching this, and this is not making sense. So that is how we ended up writing an article on what is wrong with Indian code on concrete design for earthquake. And again, we sent it to Indian Society of Earthquake Technology. And again, we were not expecting that they will publish it. They again published it. It again was very, very surprising to us that it got published. That is how I started to really get into earthquake engineering. I realized that there is a place here where I can do some really corrective, if I like, kind of a work. And while I was doing all of that, in 88, there was an earthquake in Bihar. And again, I was very fortunate to have two students. One of them is now a very senior officer in military engineering service, R.P. Tripathi, and another student, Anil Agarwal, who is now a professor in New York. And we three of us took a train without any announcement, without any prior preparation, took a train, landed up in Patna, had no idea what we are going to do, hired a taxi, went around northern Bihar, 72 hours, back-to-back from railway station to railway station. We had slept maybe 3 or 4 hours. But it was a life-changing experience to see how people were suffering because of an earthquake, how they could have lived better, how deaths could have been reduced, injuries could have been reduced. And that was a life-changing experience. So here I was looking at the code and said, oh, this code doesn't make sense. And here I was looking at the constructions. And all of this changed my life. I just said, I can't do anything other than earthquake engineering. It doesn't matter whether there is an opportunity to do work or not. And that is how, around the time I met Dr. Murthy at IIT Delhi, and Murthy and I then started to what became very successful series of short courses. And in fact, I was able to persuade Murthy to join me at Kanpur IIT. And for the next 15 years, we really did some wonderful work. Somewhere along, Durgesh Rai joined me from Roorkee again. And we just went on doing whatever we felt like doing. Kanpur gave us so much freedom. Nobody ever asked us what you are doing. Nobody ever questioned us why you are doing this. Nobody ever came in our way. Of course, it was never expected that they will give us any reward or they will give us fast promotions or they will do anything for us. But they would let us do things. They would enable us to do whatever we wanted to do. And there was a very conducive environment where people will not poke their nose in our work. People will not come in our way. It was in that kind of a situation that I would once in a while be asked to do some administrative work. Several of the people here talked about deanship. That was something that I needed to do to repay my debt to IIT Kanpur. But then it gave me a great opportunity to learn things about what is education, what is academic institution. And it is around that time that 8 new IITs were created. And that is another story how I ended up being interviewed for that. And I was interviewed in Shastri Bhavan in December of 2008. And after my interview was over, the secretary HRD asked me, out of the 8 IITs, which IITs would be your preferred IIT? And I said, if you give me Gandhinagar, I'm happy to go. Otherwise, I'm happy to be in Kanpur. And the idea was that I was doing well in earthquake engineering. I was a committed soldier for earthquake safety, and I just didn't want to compromise on that. I just was very, very comfortable. But if I were to build an institution, it has to be on my terms, and it can be only in Gujarat, because by the time I had some experience of working in Gujarat through the 2001 earthquake onwards. And very fortunately, they asked me to go to Gandhinagar. I came with very romantic ideas. I came up with the idea that I'll hire some really, I thought I was pretty good in motivating people. I thought many people will come and join me. In fact, in first month of joining IIT Gandhinagar, we made 5-year offers to Professor Dheera Sanghi, who talked to you a few minutes back, and Professor Rajat Muna, who is now director of IIT Bhilai. And I thought, I'll get these two guys from IIT Kanpur, and they will help me just run the institute. You know, I will just be taking their help. And very soon, my entire concept was broken. Neither Dheeraj nor Rajat were willing to move. And that is when I realized that I will not be able to run the institute the way I had thought it should be run. And that is when we started to rely on senior citizens from IIT Bombay, IIT Kanpur. Many of you are here, but many of you are not in the room, and on young faculty. In fact, I have been accused of child labor, if I like, of using a 28-year-old, 29-year-old, 30-year-old, 32-year-old young faculty, asking them to do the job that I would have done at the age of 40 or 45. And I must say that they have absolutely surprised me with the energy, with the wisdom, with the maturity, and with the commitment, not just the faculty, but the staff and everybody. I remember very fondly the episode that Jason and I, Sanjeev Pandey here, Santosh Raut here, four of us, we spent outside a police thana the entire night. We spent outside the police thana because there was an episode involving our students. And we just said, we can't leave our students in the custody of the police. We have to be here. And it was only around 4 o'clock, 4:30. Artisha is here. In fact, Koshi and Artisha, they came back. And I mean, if Artisha is not embarrassed, let me just tell you the kind of commitment that people have shown. So here were these students who went into some episode, and there was some law and order situation. And the police took our students and took the opposite side. And Jason and I said, we cannot go home. We cannot leave our boys in the police without being here. And the police staff was telling us, you go, aap jaake so jao, hum kar lenge, aap kyon parshan ho, hum log hai na, aap kyon chinta karte ho. He said, nahi, theek hai, aapko jo karna karo, hum bahar baithte hain. So there was a culvert outside, Jason and I were sitting, Santosh and Sanjeev, they were communicating between us and the police inspector back and forth. And a point came where the police inspector realized that these guys are pretty stubborn, they are not going to go. So he said to Sanjeev Pandey that I'm going to arrest you now. You are disturbing my work by coming several times. And now our next project was to get Sanjeev Pandey out, not just worry about our students. So finally we were able to get Sanjeev Pandey out, and Santosh fortunately wasn't in the police inspector's radar. And then certain things happened, and our boys played it a little smart. And around that, Artisha and Koshi, they came to the police station, and then we were able to all go home around maybe 4:35, 5:30 or something like that. Now the deal was the following. The deal was that these boys of ours, they were supposed to be arrested, but they created a situation where they could be admitted in a hospital. And this was perhaps a Friday, I forget the exact details. So then the Saturday, Sunday, the courts are closed, and Monday they will be released from the hospital. But then they have to surrender to the police, and somebody has to go for getting their bail. And I called Arti Shah, and I said, Arti had joined us as a accounts officer from Government of Gujarat, and I asked Arti, we need you to help us with the bail for these three boys. We have three boys there. And he called the lawyers and all that, and they said, as a class one officer in Government of Gujarat, you are allowed to ask bail for two. Now there are three boys. So we needed another class one officer. So he said, Arti, how do we get the other class two? He said, don't worry, sir, main apne dost ko le jaunga, wo kara dega bail. So now here they are, Arti and his friend, whom I had not met, going to Kachari, trying to get bail for three of our boys. And I'm holding with absolute anxiety when the bail will be granted. So it is 3 o'clock, it is 4 o'clock, it is 5 o'clock, it is 6 o'clock, it is 7 o'clock, and I don't want to disturb RT because I know I have a responsible man in the kachari, and I don't know what situation he is in, and I cannot be distracting him. Around 7:30, he called me. He said, "Sab, ho gaya sab, everything is sorted out, and bail has been granted, and we are all going from the kachari, and I'll come and meet you tomorrow." Fine, thank you very much. Next morning, Arti comes to me, and I said, "What happened?" He says, "Sab, wo judge saab ad gaye." Bole, "Tu class one officer ho, theek hai, chalega. Lekin mujhko property ke paper dikhao. And I want your property papers to be endorsed in some form." Now, what it meant was that Arti and his friend went home, took out their property papers, went back to the kachari, got it endorsed in whatever format the kachari wanted, and that is how they could get the bail of those three boys. That is the level of commitment that people have shown. And RT is only one example. And imagine his friend doing it for IIT Gandhinagar, whom we have never met through RT. So this is the kind of commitment that made me realize that when in December 2008, I told the government of India that if you send me to IIT Gandhinagar, I'm happy to go. That was a very wise thing. I don't think that's kind of episode that I'm telling you about RT Shah. I don't know, he had been with us maybe a few months, maybe a month or 2 months. He was not a very long with us at the time. That commitment, not only he, but so many others that have shown, is what made not only what IIT Gandhinagar is today, but made me made me enjoy my work, made me do well, made me feel that I'm doing the right thing. It is in this spirit that I must say that when this Padma Shri Award was told to me, I was absolutely surprised, I was absolutely shocked. But later I realized that it is really not me, it is really all of us, all in this room and outside this room, who have really collectively worked for it. And the reason I told you a little bit of story of IIT Kanpur, I think the kind of training that Kanpur gave me, the kind of opportunities Kanpur gave me, and the kind of friendships and associations and the kind of work we could do in earthquake safety, I think all of that, most grateful to all of you. Thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much for having confidence in me and supporting whatever, in fact, the joy of working in IIT Gandhinagar has been that I would just come up with some crazy idea, call a few people and say, let's do it. And invariably, in 90% cases, 95% cases, people will say, yes, we will do it. They won't worry about how much it will affect or disrupt their family or their own time or their own academic plans. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you for this wonderful event and your affection. And we have a lot more work to do. The government of India asked me to continue for 5 more years. Before that, there was a feeler that I should perhaps move on to some other institution. And I just didn't think that having raised IIT Gandhinagar from where it was to where it is, I just didn't think that I'm fit now for any other institution. I just didn't think that I can do justice to any other institution. I thought it would be very unfair if I were to go anywhere else, and I would never be able to get over IIT Gandhinagar. I will continue to keep telling them Gandhinagar stories, and that would not be fair to them. And my contention was that I don't want anything. Thank you so much. But if you want me to go to Gandhinagar, I'm happy to go to Gandhinagar. And fortunately for me, and I would say that they asked me to continue here, and therefore we have a lot more work to do. And as Jason is saying, what was the word? He's a pain, so I hope to remain pain for everybody who is around me. Don't expect anything different. And as Michel Denino said, compassion and ruthlessness, I don't know about compassion part, but certainly ruthlessness part. Many of my colleagues have heard from me. The word ruthlessness is something that I have used very frequently, and I think we have to continue to use those words. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you so much, Professor Jain.